हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. सी, दिस इज योर लेक्चर नंबर 8 ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 3, मेजर्स ऑफ सेंट्रल टेंडेंसी फॉर द स्टैटिस्टिक्स सब्जेक्ट. सी, इन अवर लास्ट लेक्चर वी कंप्लीट अप टू इलस्ट्रेशन नंबर 21 एंड टू मेथड्स, राइट? टू मेथड्स फॉर द मीडियन. एंड आई वाज गिव यू इन द होमवर्क सेक्शन बीज फोरसम एंड सेक्शन सीज फोरसम, दैट इज मिक्सचर ऑफ मीन एंड मीडियन, दैट इज एक्सरसाइज 3, सेक्शन बी एंड सेक्शन सी इज मिक्सचर सम. ओके, आई होप यू ऑल कंप्लीट दैट. एंड इफ यू हैव डाउट्स देन व्हाट्सएप मी एनी टाइम. एंड नाउ वी विल कंटिन्यू मूव फॉरवर्ड टू अवर नेक्स्ट मेथड, दैट इज मेथड नंबर 3, कंटिन्यूअस फ्रीक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. सी, इन अवर लास्ट लेक्चर वी शो दैट वी कैन फाइंड आउट द मीडियन फ्रॉम ऑफ रो मटेरियल, दैट इज रो डेटा, दैट इज अनग्रुप डेटा एंड द डिस्क्रीट ग्रुप डेटा. ओके, नाउ सी द फॉर्मूला हियर. फॉर कंटिन्यूअस फ्रीक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन देर आर क्लास इज गिवन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ क्लास इज गिवन, एक्सक्लूसिव टाइप ऑफ क्लास एंड इंक्लूसिव टाइप ऑफ क्लास. वी विल सी इट लेटर, बट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी सी दैट वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट हियर मीडियन क्लास फर्स्ट. What is median class? For find out median of continuous group data, we have to find out a median class first, right? For that, the formula is n by tooth class obtaining in the n by tooth observation. Class of n by tooth observation. This is the formula for median class. For find out median, first of all we have to find out the median class by this formula, and then we can write the original formula for median. Median is equal to m is equal to L plus n by 2 minus CF upon F into C, right? This is the formula. L plus n by 2 minus CF upon F into C. This is the formula. And write down that where L is equal to CF is equal to F is equal to and C is equal to. What is L? First of all, L is a lower boundary point of the median class. L means lower boundary point of median class. Then CF is equal to what? CF is equal to cumulative frequency, but CF is equal to here cumulative frequency of the class prior to the median class. Cumulative frequency of class prior to the median class, right? Now frequency is equal to frequency of the median class. And the last one, C is equal to class length of median class. See, this is the formula, and you have to know all the long form of the L, CF, F, and C. What is L? Lower boundary point of median class. First of all, you have to find out the median class from the given data by using this formula, class of the n by 2th observation. And then after this median class, you have to find out these poles. Which one is? First one is L. L is equal to lower boundary point of a median class. You have to find out the lower boundary point, right? Two types of data in continuous distribution. First one is inclusive type of data and second one is exclusive type of data. And from that, we have to find out the lower boundary point. Second one is CF, but we have to find out the CF, that is cumulative frequency. But here we have to write CF of the previous class, or you can say prior class to the median class, right? Then F is a frequency of a median class and C is the class length of the median class. Okay, this is the formula. First of all, write down this formula, and this one is a 5-mark sum, so it is an important one. That's why please remember this formula, because it is used in next few chapters. Okay, so it is most important. Please write down and remember it. Okay, so now two types of class is given here. Which one? See here, I remove this. See, there are two types of classification, right? We have to we can understand this in chapter number 2, but here we are skipping the chapter number 2 and we are directly start the chapter number 3. That's why we have to know here what is inclusive type of classification and what is exclusive type of classification. Okay, so whenever the data is given, see here I am giving the example of these two. See here, whenever the data is given 0 to 9, 10 to 19, 20 to 29, 30 to 39, it is an example of inclusive type of classification. And same way, whenever 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, and 30 to 40, this type of classification is given, or if this type of class is given, then you can say it is an exclusive type of class. See, what is the lower boundary point of the class? First of all, for median, find out the median, we want L first. What is that? See here, whenever exclusive type of classification is given, these all are lower boundary point. That can be said that here, if the 20 to 30 is the median class. See here, first of all, we have to find out the median class by the formula n by 2th observation, right? And if we found out that 20 to 30 is the median class, then what is L? Here, 20 is your lower boundary point of the median class, right? Because here, upper boundary point of the previous class is 20 and here the lower boundary point of the current class is also 20. So whenever 10 is equal, 20 equal, 30 equal, 40 is equal, that means upper class limit or upper boundary point of the previous class and the lower boundary point of the current class is equal. It is called exclusive type of classification. And at that time, we just have to take the lower boundary point of from the class, that is 20, right? But when inclusive type of classification is given, see here, the main thing is here, when inclusive type of classification means what? 0 to 9, then not 9, then 10 to 19, then again not 19, here 20 to 29, and here not 29, here 30 to 39. That means difference between the upper class limit of previous class and lower class limit, lower boundary point of the current class is 1. The difference is there. Here there is no difference. See, 10, 10, 20, 20. There is no difference between upper boundary point and the lower boundary point between two class. Here the difference between upper boundary point and the lower boundary point of different two class, that's why it is called an inclusive type of classification. And at that time, see, first of all, find out the difference between these two. The difference is 1. Here, first of all, 10 minus 9 is equal to 1. Or you can say 20 minus 19, that is 1. See, the difference is equal, that is 1. Because it is a continuous group data and the difference is always 1. That's why, first of all, we have to find out the difference between the lower boundary point and upper boundary point of two different classes, right? Successive classes, right? So here, the difference is 19 minus 10, 10 minus 9, so it is 1. And now, it is the difference between two class, that's why we have to divide by 2. What is the answer? The answer is 0.5. First of all, find out the difference, 10 minus 9, that is 1. Then, see here, I'm doing 1 divided by 2 is the next step. So, the difference is 0.5. Now, here we have to convert inclusive type of classification into exclusive type of classification. First of all, whenever inclusive type of classification is given, we have to convert it into exclusive type of classification, and then we can find out the L from that, that is lower boundary point from that. So here we can convert in exclusive types of classification from inclusive, that this difference, we have to subtract this from this and we have to add this from this. See here, we have to subtract and we have to add here. Here we have to subtract and here we have to add. Then and then we can find out the, we can convert the inclusive type of classification into exclusive type of classification. So 0 minus 0.5, 0 minus 0.5, that is minus 0.5, and 9 plus 0.5, that is 9.5. See here, this minus this. What is this? See here, this is a 0, 10, 20, 30, lower boundary. And this one is the upper boundary, 9, 19, 29, 39, right? We have to subtract this difference. First of all, we have to find out the difference between two, lower and upper. And then we have to divide, because divided by 2, because this is the difference of two class. That's why divided by 2. And what is the answer? We have to subtract from lower and added to the upper boundary. See here, now subtract from this, 10 minus 0.5, what is the answer? 9.5. See in your calci, 10 minus 0.5, that is 9.5, and 19 plus 0.5, that is 19.5. again, 20 minus 0.5, that is 19.5, and then 29 plus 0.5, that is 29.5. Right? Then again 30 minus 0.5, that is 29.5, and 39 plus 0.5, that is 39.5. See now, the difference, the class lower class boundary and upper class boundary, lower class limit or upper class limit is equal, see here, right? See, that's why lower boundary point of, now see, this one is the median class. If this one is the median class, then we have to take L is equal to 19.5. See here, 19 and 20 is here, and this one is the same way here. Whatever the median class is there, we can find out by n by 2th observation, right? So here, if this one is the median class, then we have to take L is equal to what? First of all, we have to convert that into inclusive from into exclusive from inclusive, right? And then whatever is the lower boundary point of that median class, see, this one is the median class, and whatever is the lower boundary point of the median class, we have to take it is as L. That's why here L is equal to 19.5, here L is equal to 20, but here in inclusive type of classification, L is equal to 19.5. So this is the main difference we have to keep in mind. These both, whenever inclusive type is given, we have to take like this, and whenever exclusive type of classification given, we have to like we have to take like this. Okay, so this is the method, but here I have a shortcut. What is that? If exclusive type is given, we have to take as it is, no change, but whenever inclusive is given, we have to find out first of all median class, that is n by 2th observation, and then we have to subtract from this 0.5, because the difference is 1. 20 minus 19, that is 1. 1 divided by 2, that is 0.5, and just we have to subtract from median class lower boundary 0.5, and then we can find out L is equal to 19.5. Okay, so first of all, write down this, and we'll continue with our next illustration, that is illustration number 22. We complete up to, in our example book, 21 illustration, and in our exercise book 3.3 exercise, as well as exercise 3 section B's foursome and section C's foursome. I hope you all complete that, or if not, please complete it right now. Okay, now, okay, after this we'll start with the our illustration, next illustration, that is illustration number 22. Please write down these, all these things into your fair book, that is into your example book. Okay, now illustration number 22. See, first of all, I am reading the question. The number of checks deposited into the bank per day has the following frequency distribution, that is number of checks 0 to 39, 40 to 79, 80 to 119, 120 to 159, and 160 to 199. See, this is which type of data, or you can say which type of classification is given into the question. See, 0 to 39, and the next class is 40 to 79. So it is an inclusive type of classification is given, and we have to find out L from that. So first of all, I am writing the question, and then I'll explain you which we have to take number of checks. That is your class, not your X. See here, in the continuous group data, X is not given. you have to find out x by finding out the mid values of the class. Okay, so here checks is given, then number of days, that is your f. See 0 to 39, then 42, 79, then 82, 119, 122, 159, and 162, 199. And what is the frequency here? 2, then 14, then 23, then 7, and then 4. What is your n, that is your sigma fi? 30 20, that is 50, right? Now see here, whenever continuous group data is given, we have to find out, see I told you, we have to find out the x for the mid values by finding out the mid values, but here we don't need any x, because here we have to find out median, not mean. If we want to find out mean, we have to find out the mid values. But here, whenever we have to find out the median, we just have to prepare one column, that is cumulative frequency. When we want to find out mean, we have to find out first of all mid values, but here we don't have to find out mean. Here the question asks find out the median, find the median number of checks deposited. So whenever we have to find out the median, we have to just prepare one column, that is CF, cumulative frequency. And what is the calculation for that? 2 as it is, no change, then 14 plus 2, that is 16, then 16 plus 23, that is 39, then 39 plus 7, that is 46, and 46 plus 4, that is 50. Always the total of the frequency is the last term of cumulative frequency. Okay, now we have to find out from this, first of all, median class. What is the formula for median class? See here, we have to find out the class of the n by 2th observation, right? So here I am writing that class of n by 2th observation. What is the n by 2? What is n, first of all, that is 50. Class of 50 by 2 observation, that is class of 25th observation. See here, whenever we have to find out the median of continuous group data or a discrete group data, we have a frequency and we have a cumulative frequency. So we have to find out this 25th observation in which column? In cumulative frequency column. So here, when 25th observation is lies between 16 to 39, see, it is lies between 16 to 39. No, here it is not a discrete group data. Whenever we have to find out the discrete group data, we have to see here. But here we have to see that what is our class, that is our class is 78, 82, 119. See, 25th observation is lies between these two, 16 to 39. So we can say that here it is the median class. First of all, we have to find out the class of n by 2th observation, that is class of 25th observation. This 25th we have to find out into the cumulative frequency column. See here, it is lies between 16 to 39, right? So 25 is it is the class of median class is 82119. So here we can write that therefore median class is equal to 82119, right? And from that, see here, what is the formula for median? L plus n by 2 minus cf upon f into c. For that we have to find out first of all L. What is L? See here, it is which type of classification? It is inclusive type of classification, and we have to convert into exclusive type. So here, what is the difference between these two? 1, 1, 1, 1, right? 39 plus 1, 40, 79 plus 1, 80, 119 plus 1, 120. So the difference is 1. First of all, find out the difference between upper and lower class, that is 1. Then divide it by 2, because this is the difference of 2 class, right? That's why divided by 2, the answer is 0.5. And to find out the lower boundary point, we have to subtract from these. That is 80 minus 0.5. Find out in your calci what is the answer. 80 minus 0.5, that is 79.5, is the lower boundary point of this class. So here at L we have to take 79.5, because this is the lower boundary point of this median class. Okay, now see what is CF here. This is the what is the full form of CF here? Cumulative frequency of the class prior to median class. This one is the median class. See, this one is the median class, and this is the cumulative frequency of that particular median class. But we have to take prior to median class cumulative frequency. That means here, this one is the prior to median class cumulative frequency. So we have to take 16 as CF. What is CF? See again, CF is equal to cumulative frequency of the class prior to median class. What means of that? This is the median class, and this is the median class cumulative frequency. We want the prior class cumulative frequency, that is previous class cumulative frequency, that is 16. So here CF is equal to 16. Now what is F? Frequency of median class. This one is the median class, and this is the frequency of median class, right? So we have to write as F is equal to 23, right? Okay, now see the difference, that is class length. Now last one is the C, that is class length of the median class. See, if we find out like this, 119 minus 80, that is the difference of the class is 39. If you write down that the class length of this class or all this class is 39, here you are always wrong. See, whenever inclusive type of classification is given, here we have to find out the class length by subtracting these two, or you can say these two, that is lower boundary minus lower boundary of two class, upper boundary or upper boundary of two class, not the difference between these two, but we have to find out the difference between these two and these two, or you can say these or these, right? So whenever inclusive type of classification is given, class length is not finding out by subtracting these two, we have to subtract these two, these or these or these, right? So we can find out the actual boundary class length of the two class. So 40 minus 0, that is 40, or you can say 80 minus 40, that is again 40. So here the median class length of the median class is 40, not 39. Okay, inclusive type of classification is given. That's why this, the difference of these two is your class length 80 minus 40. That is your 40 is your C. Okay. So now I am putting just the value here. Whatever value is given, L is equal to what? 79.5 plus N by 2. Here N by 2 is equal to 25 minus CF. CF is equal to 16 divided by F is equal to 23 and multiplication by 40. See, you all know the board mass rule. BODMAS. BOD means bracket, open, then division, then multiplication, then addition, and then subtraction. We have to follow all the time for simplify this. We have to first of all sub minus and divide and multiply, and then we can add this, right? So for simplification of this, we have to write 79.5 plus. This one is as it is. First of all, minus this and multiply this. 25 minus 16, bracket open. It is 9 into 40 divided by 23. So again, 79.5 plus. Now, 9 into 40, that is 360 divided by 23. 79.5 plus 360 divided by 23, that is 15.6522. So here I am writing here is equal to 79.5 plus 15.6522. So here plus, it is, the answer is 95.1522, and your exact or approximate you can answer is 95.15, right? So 95.15 checks is deposited in, it is the median of those data. Thus, the median for number of checks deposited into the bank per day is 95.15 checks. Okay, so here is your answer. 95.15 checks is your answer. First of all, write down this. Okay, complete this. Now see, move forward to our next illustration, that is illustration number 23. I read the question here. The data about monthly expenditure on petrol for 75 families is given in the following table. See here, the data is given for 75 families, that is your total frequency, right? Now find out the median expenditure on the petrol for these families. Now see the data. The data question, style of the question is changed here. What is that? Up to 200, up to 400. Class is not given here. Expenditure rupees, in rupees, on the petrol is given into up to 200, up to 400, up to 600, up to 800. Means what? Here the class is not given. See, in our 8th illustration, see the page number 75. In 8th illustration number 8, in mean sum, the data is given below 420, below 430, below 440, right? See here, this is the less than type data. Again, this one is the less than type data. Up to 200, up to 400, up to 600 is given. Then see, this is the less than type data, same as illustration number 6. So you have to write that. First of all, you have to know that what is the median class. See here, See, the data is given like this: less than 200, less than or equal to 200, less than or equal to 400, less than or equal to 600, and so on. But we have to convert these into the continuous group data. Okay, so we have to write the answer like this. First of all, here illustration number 23, and see, expenditure in rupees on petrol that is your class. Now frequency that is number of families that is your frequency. And then we want cumulative frequency. That is CF. Now, first of all, what is the data? It says up to 200. We have to write same. That is up to 200, because here the lower is not given. That in illustration number 8, 410 is lower gram. See, in illustration number 8, page number 75, 410 is the lowest weight, or you can say minimum weight of the mangoes, right? It is given that. But here the lowest expenditure is not given. So we have to write that up to 200 as it is, no change in this. Okay. So here up to 200 as it is, no change. Then 200 to 400. Next class is 200 to 400. Then next class is 400 to 600. Then next class is 600 to 800. Then next class is 800 to 1000, and the next class is 1000 to 1200. Okay, so up to 200, 200 to 400, 400 to 600, 600 to 800, 800 to 1000, and 1000 to 1200 is given. See, now the frequency is given, but here it is not a frequency, here it is always cumulative frequency. See, up to 200, 2, so we have to write 2 as it is. That is up to 200, 2 families, expenditure is up to 200. Now 200 to 400, see here the data is up to 800, up to 400, but we want 200 to 400. So here I told you that in illustration number 8, that whenever this type of data, less than type of data is given, we have to subtract second from first from the second. That's why 8 minus 2, we have to take 6. This is our original frequency. Next one is 17. So 17 minus 8, that's why it is 9. Then 32 minus 17, that is 15. Then 57 minus 32, that is again 25. And the last one is 75 minus 57, it is 18. This one is the original frequency. We have to find out whenever up to 200, up to 400, up to 600 is given. We have to convert this data into continuous group data, and then we can find out the original frequency also. See here, second minus first, third minus second, fourth minus third, fifth minus fourth, and sixth minus fifth. This is the way to find out the original frequency whenever the data is given up to so and so amount or below so and so amount. Okay, so here we are finding out the original frequency. Now the cumulative frequency. See, 2 plus 6, that is 8, plus 9, that is 17. See, whenever below the date, below so and so amount or up to so and so amount, always at that time whatever given into the question, that is your cumulative frequency. Keep in mind that whenever below or up to word is given into the question, frequency is given is your cumulative frequency. So you have to find out, not you don't have to find out anything, you just have to write that 2 plus 2, then 8, then 17, then 32, then 57, and then last is 75, and here the total, that is sigma f, is equal to 75. Okay, so here the data, the question style is changed again here. You have to keep in mind all these different ways of style of the questions, right? So you can give the answer exactly. If you know the formula only, then you cannot get the answer. If you know the method, if you know the style of the question, then and then you can get the answer. You can know the original answer. Okay, now first of all, we have to find out from this median class. What is median class? That is class of n by 2 observation. See here, not n plus 1 by 2 observation. In discrete group data as well as in ungrouped data, we have to take n plus 1 by 2 observation. But in a continuous group data, 1 is not there, only n by 2 observation is here. So class of 75 by 2 observation, that is what? Class of 37.5 observation. 37.5, that is what? It is lies between 32 and 57, right? 37.5 lies between 32 and 57. So your original median class is equal to 800 to 1000. Therefore, you can write here median class is equal to 800 to 1000, right? And this is which type of data? This is the exclusive type of classification. That's why we have to take L is equal to what? We have to subtract anything here? No, because here upper boundary is 800 as well as the lower boundary is also 800. 200 200 400 400 600 600 800 800. So it is a exclusive type is given here, and that's why we have to take here L is equal to what? As it is, no change, 800. Then CF is equal to what? Cumulative frequency of the class prior to the median class. Prior to the median class, that is 32. Then what is F? F is equal to frequency of the median class, that is 25. And C, that is class length, is equal to what? Here we can subtract these two because it is an exclusive type. That's why 1000 minus 800, that is 200. Class length is 200. Okay, so now I'm writing the original formula. L plus n by 2 minus CF upon F into C. L is equal to 800 plus n by 2 is equal to what? N by 2 is equal to 37.5 minus CF is equal to 32 divided by F is equal to 25 and C is equal to 200. So here 800 plus, subtract this 5.5 into 200 divided by 25. So here 800. So here 1100 is here, 1100 divided by 25, 5.5 into 200, 1100 divided by 25, that is 800 plus 44, and the answer, ultimate answer is 844. See, the last answer is 844, and you can write that, thus the median monthly expenditure on petrol of this family is rupees 854. Okay, so this is your illustration number 23. Please write down this first of all. And now it is the time for homework. See, I am writing the homework here. Exercise 3.4, only one question, that is question number 5, which is like this, right? So we have to write only one question in your homework for exercise 3.4. Now from exercise 3, see, section B and section C is over. Section B, short sums for median and mean, is over. Now section D, question number 9, section D, question number 9, then question number 10, it is again the mixture of mean and median, right? Question number 11, and question number 12.